Marhaba, and welcome to the Matrix Green Pill, where real people connect.
Hello, hello, and welcome back to the Matrix Green Pill podcast. My name is Melvin Abraham, and joining me today is the dazzling and dynamic Shirin, Oz as we call her. Hey, Oz.
Hi, Mel. I'm so happy to be doing another podcast with you today. Our guest is Madhav Dar. He's actually someone like me who was born in Sharjah in the United Emirates. Then he began his real estate career, obviously down the line at Damac Group. Madhav was entrusted with leading the marketing operations and the sales activations across international markets. His wealth of knowledge in the field, Madhav co-founded Zazen Properties and took the role of chief operating officer, handling the real estate product development from conception to delivery. What an excellent journey, Madhav. Welcome. And it's lovely to have you here with us today.
Thank you for having me. Great to know you're born in Sharjah, probably a different hospital because I'm much older than you. Good to have another Sharjah person.
Yes, likewise.
We're looking to have more of that spontaneity, Madhav, on the show, but I'm going to dive straight in. And if you could give us a small introduction to yourself and a quick recap on your background and your life here in the UAE.
So like Shirin said, I was born in Sharjah, grew up in Dubai until about the age of 7. I was shipped off to a boarding school at that age, studied abroad all my life, came back basically when I was about 26 in 2006. And, you know, I've been fortunate to grow up and live through different cultures and different experiences across different countries. And I believe that's really helped shape not only my attitude towards how I approach life in a general manner, but how I do business and what we want to bring to the table with Zazen as a brand and the experience we want to create for people. That's just in a nutshell. In terms of my background, obviously I've been in advertising and marketing my whole life. I switched then into real estate and into the marketing division and then into the operations division of real estate. And in 2018, that full journeys led me to create Zazen with very strong partners who had the same vision as me.
Making the switch from marketing towards real estate and operations. So let's jump into your real estate career. Could you give us a short brief about your journey and what was it about the profession that first appealed to you?
I started within advertising and I worked on global brands, for example, HTC smartphones or Citibank, and with a lot of big local brands in UAE. Part of my portfolio in advertising was real estate. Learning about real estate, understanding the business, it was only from an advertising perspective. I was fortunate enough to then move in-house. In that experience, I learned more about the marketing side of the entire gamut of real estate. And growing up in Dubai, you know, seeing Sheikh Zayed Road as two sand roads leading to Abu Dhabi, and then seeing what happened by the time 2010 or 2011 hit, it was very intriguing. And that helped me make the decision to move into real estate from advertising. Through that time, obviously, I learned how to manage across different markets. The real estate business in general in Dubai is very active. Maybe not now, but back in 2010 and 11, it was high-paced, high-intensity atmosphere, teaches you a lot. Luckily, within advertising, you learn to deal with chaos and manage chaos in the right way to get the right result. And I think that really helped me within real estate. And I worked my way up with a couple of big developers. Through that time, obviously, you learn, you understand the market. And being from Dubai, I wanted to be part and I wanted to contribute to what Dubai would be over the next 10 or 15 years.
Brilliant. Okay. And then how did you decide to take that leap and start your own business?
We started Zazen in 2018, at the end of 2018. At that time, the market was very, very supportive for people trying to enter as a developer. So the price point was correct. Buying a plot of land wouldn't cost you an arm and a leg. Well, it would cost you an arm and a leg, but it's still cheaper than other markets. We had a clear vision, you know, we understood where the market was heading. There were certain aspects that were not being served within this market. Zazen was sort of born out of that thought. We said, okay, what do we want to contribute to Dubai and what will Dubai look like over the next 5 years? It's not just about putting up a building. It's about creating an experience for people who want to live in a home, not just live in an apartment or live in a villa. We were very clear in terms of what we wanted to deliver. Price point was correct. at that time. And obviously, we had to learn about the rules and regulations and make sure we abided by all of those things. It's sort of, you know, the perfect storm to get into that niche segment within real estate. And that's what Zazen has been based on.
I guess my next question was going to be, in a nutshell, if you could just do an elevator pitch of Zazen. Obviously, you've already given us a very good understanding about what it is and what you were trying to do. But yeah, if you could just do an elevator pitch, what would it be?
You need to add some elevator music for this. That would be perfect.
We'll add that in later.
Look, Zazen as a brand aims to balance quality, community, sustainability, and affordability. These are the four main USPs of what we'd like to create. We want to create a community within a building itself. What that means is what you see in a master community, we want to bring that or as much of that into a single building. We always want to add value to Dubai's real estate landscape for the long term. We're not here to try and make a quick buck and run away. We are here to help build Dubai towards the future.
I'm going to pick on something that you've mentioned, which I think is very important now, but I want to hear from your perspective. So why do you think sustainability is important, especially in the current real estate industry? And another thing that's been on my mind is, how did you come up with the name Zazen?
So I'll answer your second question first. Zazen is actually the perfect posture while meditating. That's what it boils down to. We like that idea. Not because we wanted to be a Zen development and nothing to do with that, but we like the idea of stillness, calmness, relating what we create to basically having that peace of mind and having the composure to sort of think through all the various things that go through your mind at any given moment. That's what Zazen means, and that's what we envisioned it as. To be honest, it was also a really cool name, and it was short, and it sort of made sense and it stood out. So it worked on all fronts.
I really love that you have got this story and it's not just, oh, it was a cool name and we liked it.
As a young sort of homegrown business, we have to differentiate ourselves and we try to think through every decision that we make. In real estate, it's not about creating a building. You know, as a consumer, you think, oh, it made this building, but this is not good in the apartment and I wish they had this and I wish they had that, or why didn't they do this? So people think it's that simple. It's not that simple because, you know, you need to obviously balance costs versus what you can give to the market versus what you can earn from the market. It's an entire strategy and thinking that goes through it. And at the end of the day, as brands are Zen, we put ourselves in the shoes of the customer and we said, okay, I wanted to live in a community, which is not just sit in your apartment and then I'll see you once a week in the elevator. I may say hi, may not say hi. We wanted to build an inclusive community, well, like you would find maybe in Europe or maybe you'd find in India or other parts where you know each other, you know your neighbor. You know, there are spaces to interact and unwind and work and live and be with your family. We wanted to provide all of that. So that was the thought behind Zazen. Getting to your question on sustainability. Look, consumers now in general, they understand how being sustainable allows you to help, I guess, the planet in a very small way. So they will always gravitate towards it. Not many people understand what sustainable living really means. The challenge is actually educating and then obviously balancing the concept of sustainability with the design of the building, with the facilities or the amenities that you give in the building. Because at the end of the day, you may be green conscious, but you'd not be willing to give up good quality of living. So having a nice apartment, good finishings, having nice facilities within the building just to be green. Because if you're spending your hard-earned money on finding a home, not just a house, a home, you want to get value out of it. It's a very fine balance and involves a lot of education and for developers to strategize about it in the right way from the start. Obviously, there's also the added cost benefit. For example, putting solar panels will help reduce the energy consumption of your building. Our first project, Zazen 1, which is in JVT, we have solar panels on the roof. And those solar panels will aim to contribute about 25% of the electricity required for the building to operate annually. The end user or the buyer lower service charges, because they don't have to pay high service charges to cover that cost. So we thought through all of this from the start. Many developers, they may choose not to do it or they may choose to do it later. It's a strategy that needs to be part of your brand at its core. And of course, you need to educate not only stakeholders, but consumers as well about it.
So you've mentioned some of the positives. Obviously, there's many of sustainability, but what were some of the challenges that were associated with developing such a business?
The main thing is balancing the cost, because at the end of the day, getting into a sustainable development, what does that mean? That means that the material you use in the building has to be sustainable. The glass you use has to be sustainable. It has to have specific reflection properties. The way the water is consumed and pushed around the building has to be done in a specific way. So we are actually Turkey's LEED green building certified. Along with that comes a list of things that we have to adhere to from the start. So our contractor, our subcontractors, everyone has to be brought onto the same page. And when you're working with multiple people who provide different aspects while creating a development, that has to be managed properly. Also, you have to understand that aligning the stakeholders is also important, where you have investors and multiple partners in a business coming up and saying, oh, by the way, we need to pay, for example, an extra $1 million to be sustainable. They have to understand what that $1 million will get them in the long term. Is it a brand exercise and they get cost for it when they're selling? So these are the things that need to be thought through and talked about it at the start, which is a challenge, because at the end of the day, look, you're in the business to make money. Yes, at least for me, I can't speak for anyone else, but for our brand, Brands Are Zen, we're in this long term. What that means is by providing a sustainable development, by providing multiple amenities and facilities, as you would find in a master community or within a building, but still being at an affordable price point, means that the only people to lose out is us as a brand in terms of net profit, because obviously we're making less because we're spending more. It's a trade-off. But again, as I mentioned at the start, Dubai is home. Zazen is a homegrown brand, and we are here for the long term, not to make a quick buck and bounce.
Okay, so it seems like you've put a lot of thought into Zazen. And I just wanted to ask you, was this something right from the beginning? So if you were to give advice to an aspiring entrepreneur, what would it be if they are keen on starting their own business?
We thought about all of this from the start. As an entrepreneur, it's a difficult question. I started very late. I was 38 when I started Zazen with my partners. I mean, we were lucky enough to have the same beliefs and the same goals in creating a brand. But as an entrepreneur, the first thing I would say is, look, take a risk when you're younger because you have less people to worry about. You may not be married. You may not have kids. So it's easier to take risks at that time, as scary as it might be. But the most important thing, and I've learned this as I've worked my way up to organizations, is that you always focus on not only your strengths, but always delivering quality and excellence. I know that's very cliche, but I was similar. You know, I was always thinking about money. The bottom line is great. You always need to know how much you need to make to be viable and to be sustainable as a business. If you focus on excellence and quality, you will always be able to cover up that loss in profit in the long term. Because as you build a brand name, you get many other opportunities that may not come in year 1, 2, or 3, but come year 5. Once you're established, people will talk about you. People will look out for you. That is when you leverage what you've built.
Thank you for that excellent advice. I'm sure that our listeners will really take that into consideration. Just to bring it back to Dubai, and you've already mentioned how it's an ever-evolving city, incredibly fast-paced. So what would you say you see for the future of real estate here, or at least that you hope to see?
That's a very tricky question. I'm sure if you've asked this before, you have many different answers. Look, Dubai will always go through cycles. It's normal in every market. Dubai is no different. As a developer, you have to be smart. You have to plan and gauge for what is next 3 or 5 years, what it holds. What I do know is that in Dubai and in UAE in general, we are really lucky to have leadership that is progressive. They think fast, they think on their feet, and they take action quickly. A basic example, would you rather be anywhere else in the last 2 years other than UAE? Maybe except for Israel, if you really want to go there. But this place manages situations in the best possible way. Another great example of that is the Dubai 2040 Urban Master Plan, where the goal is to make sure that community, sustainability, and I believe connectivity are at the forefront of this plan. And they want to make Dubai the best city in the world to live or work from by 2040. It's a great goal. You can see people are thinking ahead 25 years and making sure the city is developed to reach that goal. And there are very few places in the world where that can happen. Luckily for Brands Are Zen, we had the same idea in 2018. We already have larger than usual apartments to live in. We already have clean, contemporary, sustainable developments with lots of natural light and solar power. We are already in developed communities which are connected to schools, to a mall, to a hospital right off the main highway. We are fortunate enough that our thought process and the thought process of the leadership team in Dubai and the UAE in general is aligned. And we are building towards the same goals. At the end of the day, we want to build communities, whether it's within a building or whether it's actually a five-building community. The idea is to build connectivity and community in Dubai. And that's what we believed was missing, or not missing, but it was getting there, but not fast enough. And we wanted to push the envelope and push what a mid-segment consumer could get in Dubai. Just because you can only afford 900 dirhams a square foot and not 1500 doesn't mean that you shouldn't be able to live comfortably and live connected and live in a community. That was our thought, and we're lucky to be aligned in the strategic vision that Dubai has. In general, we've all learned living in Dubai or growing up in Dubai or working here a few years that you can never write off this city or this country, because there is always something in planning, always something that is revealed at the right time. And I believe that will continue as manufacturing and the industrial industry opens up in Dubai. Again, you need to realize that takes time. It's not that, you know, it was announced last year and then a year later it should be done. People are spoiled in Dubai. They want everything immediately, but things like this take time. We'll see the benefits of these strategies in the next 3 to 5 years. I believe the outlook is great. I believe there are things that probably not even thought about, which will probably come to the front at the right time. This is the 50th year anniversary of the UAE. I wouldn't be surprised come end of November or December, there's some other big announcement. So fingers crossed, you know, you need to trust the leadership. You need to trust, obviously, the great infrastructure and support that's there in Dubai, and leverage that when the time is right.
I'm going to bring that leadership and the goals of Dubai together and ask you, what are some of your future goals with Zazen, or basically what's next for you?
Look, we're a young brand, young company. We are learning and evolving. Our focus right now is our first project, which is Zazen One in Jumeirah Village Triangle. We want to deliver that. And that's due to hand over in January 2022, which is basically 6 or 7 months away, coming up quickly. We want to make sure we deliver that properly. It's our flagship project, our first project. Of course, we've got other plots that we've already invested in. And design work has started for those plots. It's at early stage right now, so nothing really to talk about. But we are focused on delivering projects to the best capability and to the expectations and standards of what we've set internally. And we will continue to do that over the next 3 to 5 years. Our focus will be mainly Dubai. We're always looking for new opportunities, whether it's in Abu Dhabi or somewhere else right now, but we're UAE focused. In the long term, you never know. There are lots of big markets out there, and we may venture out once we're comfortable.
Wonderful. I mean, it sounds exciting and it sounds very busy. I'm sure you've got your hands full with all these plots and plans that you have. Well, thank you for answering all our questions. It was really great to get your perspective and understand what Zazen is truly about. We've actually now come to the segment of our show where we will each ask you a few rapid fire questions. So it's like a little game show. So let's start with your favorite holiday destination.
Home.
So not a travel fan?
I've traveled a lot in my life, and a holiday is good for like a week, 10 days, but home is my favorite holiday destination.
Okay, so I'm going to dive into the next one. Sachin or Virat, the better captain?
You're asking me about cricket? Ask me about football, I'll talk to you. Okay, but I think Virat for sure.
Okay, fair answer.
Okay, I'm not sure what your music preferences are, but if you could choose 80s or 90s music, what would you choose?
Oh, 90s for sure. I'm actually a trained musician, and in my past life, I used to have a recording studio, which I built in my bedroom and produced music. So I'm a huge music fan.
Wow, that's such an interesting fact. Thank you for sharing
music
that.
Music to our ears. Okay, so now slightly different one. Operations or marketing? Your pick.
The way I see it is right now, I am the chief everything officer for this business. So I will sweep the floors. I will bring the tea and coffee. I will do operations and I will do marketing. For me, they are intertwined. Marketing is great to have. It's a benefit. But if your operations are not in place, your marketing is pointless.
Madhav, what is one thing that you do every day, no matter how busy you are?
I always take out time to spend with each of my kids separately. I think that's important because I'm a boarding school boy. I left home when I was 7 and I came back when I was 26. For me, these moments are great. Obviously, through COVID, we got to do that a lot more. But I always take out the time to do that and breathing exercises.
Very important. That's excellent. And I love that you spend time with your kids. Thank you for playing along. I feel like we learned so much through such a little short segment. And now just before we wrap up, we would like to do our green pill moment. So Madhav, what was your green pill moment, the action or event that was the turning point for your career?
Okay, that's a tough one. I sort of have a two-part answer to this, so please bear with me. So when I took the decision to move from advertising into real estate, it was a big decision because I was pretty senior within the agency that I was working with. I remember my first 2 years of working with one of the larger developers in Dubai, I was exposed to 60 markets at a time with launches happening every month. And you have tight deadlines. You need to understand what is the difference between launching in Kenya versus Saudi versus India. What are the nuances of each market? What sells? What doesn't sell? How do we take it beyond just marketing and actually converting? You need to be adaptable. You need to move quickly on your feet. It was very challenging, but something I believe that I could not have experienced anywhere else in the world and in that time, because Dubai was such a melting pot at that time for real estate in specific. When I think about it, that really, really stands out. I was sort of in the trenches and I knew if I could get through that, I had a better understanding of how to actually manage businesses on a large scale. So I would guess that was the first one. And that obviously led me to working within real estate for a long while, understanding the preferences and understanding what the customer requires and needs on the ground. I guess that led us to study the market to say, okay, this is how the real estate market in Dubai is shifting. It's becoming more end user friendly. People are able to afford mortgages more. Therefore, what they invest in needs to be worth it. At that time, the developers I was working with did not have the same mindset or the same thinking. That strategy was not their plan. It was the typical build a building, small units for investors, sell quickly, make money and move on. And we were completely not aligned. And that triggered me to go out to meet people, network, find like-minded people. And that's how Zazen was born. We wanted to make sure that we were in Unagi, taking a friend's reference, when we were creating this brand, and made sure that Zazen stands for all these things and delivers all these things as promised. So yeah, so that was my other moment.
Brilliant. Definitely some very interesting moments. And I can see how that led to you wanting to start your own sustainable development business. And I'm super excited to see how it goes for you. But thank you for sharing. You're fantastic. And it's a very interesting and inspiring story. I'm sure that the listeners will really enjoy this conversation. And just before we say goodbye, are you available on social media? Is there anywhere that the audience could possibly follow you?
Zazen UAE is our social handle across platforms. On LinkedIn, I'm there. If someone really wants to reach out to me, obviously I'm reachable. You can find us at zazen.ae, zazen.ae. We have a show unit ready in our JVT project. You're more than welcome to come have a look at what we mean when we say quality developments, because everyone has a different definition. I promise if either of you guys would ever like to come, I would love to see your reaction. And you can tell your listeners firsthand that I wasn't talking into thin air when I was talking about my project.
That sounds like a great idea. And we might just take you on that. It was very interesting for myself, and I'm sure Melwin as well, to learn more about the development world and just the real estate, especially sustainability within all of that. I really appreciate you sharing your vision and your expertise with us. So thank you so much for joining us.
Trying some Zazen now, Oz.
Yes.
At least the posture, if not the real estate.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you can meditate and think about Zazen in your mind, maybe then you'll end up buying as well.
You're a great salesman. I'll give you that as well. Yes. Very, persistent. Very good. Mm-hmm. Very good.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you for being on, and have a good one. Good luck.
All right. Thanks, guys.
If you enjoy our conversations, please like and subscribe. See you next Wednesday.